when you want to start, when you want to make a start with the border molding, leave the wax spacer inside the tray. Leave the wax spacer inside the tray. Put your torch on, definitely away from your screens, away from vulnerable items inside the clinic, and start heating. Start heating. Now, try to heat as much as possible of the stick. It is too hot now, it is too soft. We have to apply it to the tray. I am applying now the material to the external surface of the tray. To the external surface of the tray. This way. Put it inside the hot water. Wet your hand. It is too soft. Wet your hand and drive the material to the edge of the tray. Towards the edge of the flange. The edge of the flange. Make it rounded on the edge. If you end up with some material onto the fitting surface of the tray, just remove it. Don't allow it to stay there for making the impression. Make sure that all the material is smooth, continuous, following the anatomy of the tray itself. I mean, here we have an invagination for the buccal frenum. Here we have the same for the labial frenum. Here it is going with the same anatomy of the tray towards the tuberosity, etc. Okay? And it is smooth, continuous, corresponding to the width of the sulcus. Corresponding to the width of the sulcus. From outside, it looks like this. Smooth. Smooth enough. Reasonably smooth, let me say. Reasonably smooth. I'll now start heating the material. I'll flame it from outside, from the top. We don't have from inside. The material is not allowed. We don't allow it to stand into the fitting, onto the fitting surface of the tray. We heat it. We temper it in hot water bath at 55 degrees Celsius. When it is smooth enough, when it is smooth, soft enough, we put it inside. He has to relax. He has to relax. I'm telling him as if you are sleeping. As if you are sleeping. Towards the labial frenum and the buccal frenum. Towards the frenum, I'm driving the tissues downwards. In between, I'm trying to drive the material, to drive the material upwards. حرك فكك يمين شمال for the tuberosity region. We'll mold it with the coronoid process, the movement of the mandible laterally. So the coronoid process will mold the material. خلاص, finish. This is how the material, how we get the material. Eventually, it is smooth, continuous, with no burning, it's not burned, with no sharpness, with no irregularities. It is rounded, it is with mud surface, it has a mud surface now because it exhibited contact with the tissues. It's not, it's not burned, as we said. This is a good application of the material. This is an acceptable border molding, and we don't have material flowing onto the fitting surface of the tray. If we have, if there is any material onto the fitting surface of the tray, we have to remove it. We have to remove it, like this, for example. Okay, we have to remove it. Some authorities, you'll find some authorities advocating the removal of the insides of the full width of the material. You divide it in half, the inner half should be removed. You divide it in on half on top of the flange, the edge of the flange, and the inside material towards the fitting surface should all be removed. That's to limit the pressure areas, the appearance of pressure areas on the final impression. For me, I'll just do some relief. I'll do just some relief. Now, I'm doing some relief so that the material this way. Pressure areas will not appear, hopefully, on the final impression. We do the same with the other side, but with the posterior aspect, we'll put it onto the fitting surface. We don't have an edge of the flange here. We put it onto the fitting surface, following the post-dam area. Thanks.